Matchmaker.fm connects podcasters and guests. Welcome to Matched, the show where we talk to some of the most incredible guests available for an interview right now. I'm your host, James Mulvaney, founder of Matchmaker.fm, and this is Matched.
Hi, I'm Leanne, and you can find me on Matchmaker.fm.
Hi, Leanne. How's it going today?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Yeah, I'm all right. It's weird today because it's just started snowing like before, but which you don't expect in April. But apart from that, yeah, pretty good. So welcome to Matched. We always like to start these with a couple of icebreaker questions. Mm-hmm. So firstly, if you could start off by telling me, what is the worst job that you've ever had?
The worst job. I think it was a job that I was doing as like a temp after university. And it was kind of like just going through all of these files and scanning on all these files onto a system. It was just so mundane. You had to kind of tick the box when you'd done it. It was just really repetitive and you could easily fall asleep, but you couldn't because you had to actually manually do every single document by hand. Yeah, probably
it one. It sounds pretty tedious. Mm-hmm. Okay, and so next up, what's the best book you've ever read?
It changes kind of forward and back. I remember probably To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee. And at the time, I didn't know that it was a woman that wrote it until we'd done like some book review in English studies and stuff. I just thought it was really, really unique. I just thought it was so well. And it was really groundbreaking for a woman to have written that. And there was the whole play on her name and stuff. So it was neither feminine or masculine name. It's just, yeah, I thought that was a good one.
Just always sticks in your mind.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool.
Definitely.
All right. So then we got that out of the way. If you could just tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do.
Yeah. So my name's Leanne and I have a business called Leanne's Voice, which is a voiceover and speaking coach company. You might think like, what do those two things do together? Well, when you get me, you get these combinations. So I do like voiceover for Google, Adidas, those type of kind of adverts, audiobooks, explainer videos, and like online e-learning courses. And then the speaking coaching, I train women in business to speak with confidence through, I do weekly webinars, digital products, courses, audiobooks, ebooks. I just coach them on how to sound professional in an interview, how to sound upbeat on an Instagram or Facebook Live, how to sound engaged on a podcast, how to really sell yourself without kind of feeling like I'm just like a, you know, a car dealer. Do you know what I mean? That type of thing.
Without being pushy, without being like an obnoxious salesperson. And, you know, I'm curious to know, like, it sounds quite exciting. So you've done voiceover work for Adidas and Google. That's amazing. Mm-hmm. How did you get involved in doing voiceovers? Because it's quite an interesting career and it's not something that a lot of people even though we're aware of, I don't think, you know.
Yeah. And you know what's funny? With voiceover, right, you're aware of it, but it's very subliminal. So when you're on the train station, you hear them, mind the gap, mind the gap. So you're always exposed to it all the time. When you listen to Spotify, if you haven't got the premium one, you're constantly hearing the adverts, you're constantly exposed to it. But you just wasn't aware that this is a whole huge industry. Mm. So how I got into it is like many years, people said, Leanne, you should do something with your voice. I think it'd be great. And I just always ignored it. I didn't really think you could do much with it. Mm-hmm. And then 2016, I got myself a coach, got some voiceover training, did lots of workshops and stuff. And then he really trained up my voice, helped me to really perfect the sound and use my full voice register. And then he just said, like, just go and start applying for work, get a demo ready, and just put myself on websites and just really go for it. It's a with voiceover, you've got to hustle. I mean, yeah, if you're a big gun, they'll come flooding the scripts to you. Yeah. But if you're not so big in the industry, you've got to go out there and hustle, ask for the work. So that's why I kind of got into it. And just one job kind of goes to another and hustle for this. Some people don't know that they need a voiceover until you tell them. So some people have a dead website where it's just text, 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 text. And you've got to remember, like, not everybody is that great at reading. Some people need visual, some people need audio. So that's why I say, like, you know, if you want to comply with such and such a legislation, it will be great if you have me doing the audio of this part of the text, etc. So there's loads of ways you can kind of get yourself into it.
That's great. And I think hustling, you know, just go put yourself out there is really great advice in itself, like whatever you're doing, you know, because sometimes you can build a website, you can spend time creating a social media profile, but if no one knows about you, no one knows what you can do, then they're not necessarily always going to come to you. So actually, you know, making sure that you put yourself out there, and you know, even if you record some kind of demos for kind of like non-existent clients, almost, that's mm-hmm. a great way of starting, isn't it? And also, I think it's really interesting that you mentioned, obviously, you know, you're coaching people now, helping them with voice coaching and helping them kind of put their best foot forward in terms of, like, you know, when it comes to creating content for the web, or, you know, giving presentations via Zoom. And I just think that's so important in this day and age, because in a weird way, like, a lot of people now who are in business, especially entrepreneurs, you know, you kind of have to be almost like a presenter or a voiceover artist, which wasn't really a thing if you go back like 10 years.
Yeah, so true. Definitely. I totally relate to that. And so many new clients have come on board in like the last year. Like, I've got a lady who's a cake baker. So usually she'll just bake cakes and take them off to a wedding event or whichever event she's got. But now she's having to build a more heavier online profile so she can get wider reach and work. And she's great. She can make these different tier cakes with electrical engineers, a train running in, all these different stuff. Yeah. If you ask her to explain it, like on camera, put on Facebook Live, it's like she just becomes mute and she just kind of just does the work. But if you speak to her on a one-to-one, she's really engaging. So just trying to develop those people who are highly talented in one area, but just need to build up the skills of presentation, of being strong at using your own voice. Everybody's got it. But it's how is it nurtured?
And could you give me like a couple of tips? Like, if someone's perhaps, you know, they're new to this, or they're thinking, you know, I've tried to record some videos, or I've tried to record a podcast and I don't feel like I sound the best that I possibly could. What's the kind of starting points of that process look like?
Yeah, I think that with a podcast, I always say the first thing to do is definitely start it, because you know, it's not going to get any better unless you do. I think listen to some great podcasts who are the style and tone that you like. So there's many different styles. There's people who do it solo, there's conversational, there's guest spots, and really imitate great speakers. So people, I love people like Matthew McConaughey, Dame Judi Dench, Denzel Washington, Michelle Obama. Yeah. It depends on what type of style you like, because even those people, some of them are actors, some of them are just great speakers.
Yes.
They can deliver in such a way, and you've got to think, like, is your topic one that you can have jokes in it? So some things I'd say: start a podcast for sure. Slow down when you talk, because your friends and family know and understand the speed that you talk and where you shorten or chip words. But people on a podcast or people on a video will not know how you command the language. So slow down, not like you're going in slow motion, but slow down from the regular way you talk.
Yeah.
And as well, a really one that no one really uses enough is smile. Because when you say something, when you smile, it softens the tone. You sound much more friendly, much more engaging, and you can build trust and rapport. People always want to listen to someone that sounds engaging. Whether you're talking about cats, dogs, clean up the kitchen, if you sound engaging, so slow down, smile, and keep some notes just in case that podcast thought mind blog comes in. Just have a couple of notes, but do not read verbatim. Just use them to trigger and smile, and think that you're talking to your best friends as well.
Yeah, I think that's really good advice. You know, you know, that's kind of like one of the tips that I was trying to tell people is, like, try and give it like 10% more personality than you would normally have if you're just speaking to someone. Because I think, you know, when you're listening to someone on the other end of a video, or certainly if you're listening to someone on a podcast, you can't always read the body language. It's not always the same as when you're actually speaking face to face. So you've just got to emphasize your normal self just a tiny bit.
Definitely. Yeah.
Cool. Okay. So let's talk about Matchmaker, if that's okay. I'm curious to know what led you to sign up to Matchmaker.
Do you know what? Like, I'd been on like Facebook groups trying to find like podcasts I can go and guest spot on, or guests that I can come into mine. And a lot of the Facebook groups have got these stringent rules. You cannot direct message the members. And I'm like, why do you have a 32,000 group and I cannot direct message people? What's the point? I don't want to just like and comment on the page. So there were some groups I would be reaching out to. Some of them where I thought I'd love to get on with this person's show, but you're not allowed to direct message. Some of the rules are a bit crazy. So I was like, where can I go where it's not illegal to direct message someone to get onto the podcast, you know? So I think I might have just Googled it, or I saw it in one of the groups and I thought, I'm going to go and try that so I can get some guests. and then I can be a guest on someone else's thing. And mm-hmm. I just thought, it looks great. The website's easy to use. And people were responding. It's real people. They're not chats or bots or whatever. It's real people.
That's great to hear. And so can you tell me about your results? Like how have you got on using the platform? And some of the highlights perhaps of people you've spoken to or people you've interviewed?
Yeah, definitely. Like I've found, like for my structure of my podcast, I wanted to only do like a guest interview once a month. But there was, mm-hmm. last year in particular, there was such a demand for people. So many people had time to mm-hmm. book you in. I was having guests podcasts every single week from like July all the way through to December. So yeah. It was great meeting so many different people, full range of people. And because my topic is about how to speak with more confidence, it can really touch into so many different people who've got the expertise or knowledge. I just found it great, simple to use, a full wide range of people from like all over the world. Some people in business, some people in education, others had their own podcasts, some of them had no podcasts, others were big on Instagram, some of them were just starting out their business, some of them had only just developed a business on in lockdown. So there's such a wide variety of people, and I just felt the communication was always there and you always get a response.
Brilliant, that's great. Mm-hmm. And so do you think, what advice would you give to someone who's perhaps like thinking about guesting on a podcast or they're thinking about starting their own podcast?
Yeah, if you're thinking of guesting on a podcast, I think definitely write out like your skills, like who are you, what can you offer, and what relevant podcast can you go on? Because it's not just about jumping on any podcast because you think you're going to get the exposure. Like there's actually no point me going on to a podcast where they talk about sci-fi. It's not the same market. You know? And so you got to really make sure that you fit the listeners, the potential audience's niche, and mm-hmm. have a conversation. And then it's okay to say, you know what? Your podcast sounds great. I probably am not a great fit to guest spot. It'll probably one I add to my list, but maybe not one for me to guest spot. So write out your bio. What are the three key things that you can teach an audience? What value can you bring to the listeners? Email that direct message over to the podcast host and see what they think, because they know their audience. It's their baby. So they'll know if what you're going to say is going to help and encourage them or not really help their audience. So it's a final decision with the podcast host. So they know what the listeners like. And if thinking of starting a podcast, I think for sure, 100% start it. Don't get too bogged down in all that. Oh, shall I do Libsyn? Shall I do Anchor? Shall I do, all the different technologies? Just pick one. And just start, because sometimes the art of procrastination can even stop you from progressing, you know?
Completely.
So just pick one and have like your topics planned out. I mean, if you work on that knee-jerk reaction, et cetera, I'm just going to record whenever I feel, but you'll get caught out. So if you want to do like a weekly podcast, I would say bulk record as much as you can. So think of the topics. Try to do like evergreen topics as much as you can. Or if you're going to be on topic, have a shorter show where you just do, someone does 5 minutes at five and do these type of shows where they've only got 5 minutes to talk about the hot stuff on certain industry. So work out what's going to work for your life. And remember that lockdown life is changing. So you've got to be able to, what I say is whatever you're doing, be consistent. Whether you record once a month, you give it weekly, two weekly, be consistent. Everybody likes consistency.
Yes, I completely agree. And again, you know, there's I always think there's no harm in recording things in like season. So you don't have to commit to doing 52 weeks a year. Like think about, right, what are your first episodes going to be? Commit to doing those eight episodes, record them, make sure they come out once a week, every Friday or whenever you're going to push them out.
Yeah.
And then, you know, you can kind of use that time after the first season to kind of recalibrate and think, right, okay, what can I do better? Am I happy with this format? Does it need changing? You know, it can be a work in progress, I think is... doesn't always need to be like spot on from the beginning necessarily.
Yeah, definitely. And I think definitely what you're saying there is that let it be organic. You know, it doesn't have to be like, we only talk about maths. No, like let it be organic. You may start off it that way and then it can just naturally change. You know, look at Amazon. It started off only doing books. Now you can get food and you can get, you know, all of that.
No taking over complains. The world.
Yeah, take over the whole world. No one complains or shouts at Amazon. No one's just do it, you know.
Yeah, that's great. That's a good analogy, actually. I've never heard that one, but I think that's pretty cool. All right, Leanne. And just to wrap up, if people want to find out more about you, how can they get in touch?
Yeah, definitely. You can get hold of me on my website, www.leannsvoice.com. And I spell my Leanne, L-E-I-G-H-A-N-N-E. I'm on Instagram, Leanne's Voice, Twitter, Facebook, and I love a bit of TikTok. If you're not on TikTok, you've got to join the TikTok. It's just so much fun. Do not miss out on TikTok. Honestly, it's too much fun. And it's a great platform to grow and get your, you know, I don't know, your profiles really raised very, very quickly with not much effort. TikTok is too much fun.
All right. Thank you, Leanne. I really appreciate your time today. Great to speak to you.
There is an easier way to get booked onto more podcasts as a guest. Join matchmaker.fm for free today and start making connections with podcasters who are looking for guests just like you.